In the previous tutorial, that was about adding color to a washed out image, I said I'd publish a video about removing a specific color. And this new video is going to show you the implications of removing a color with actions that will also improve the process of adding color if you need to. This video is highly useful for both adding and removing color. In the last video, I concentrated on hue and saturation curves to find a specific color. To view that previous tutorial on adding color, click the eye above. And it's important you view the process in that last video, as it'll assist you in understanding how to use the hue and saturation curves. For whatever reason, when you remove color, it appears to affect the rest of the image more than the adding color process. And as I say, that's my feeling. But whatever the way of fixing color change, it remains the same for both adding and the removal process. And this is how to remove a color using hue and saturation curves. In the timeline, there's a green screen video of me with a stock image background from Pexels. The color I'm trying to remove is the yellow in my hair. So in the inspector, I'll select the color tab and click the chevron to access hue saturation curves. Click the eyedropper for hue versus sat, and in the viewer, click on the yellow in my hair. A dot appears in the hue versus sat line. I'll drag that down and you'll see that not only has the yellow on my hair gone white, but also the skin tones have desaturated. So what's needed is a way to separate the face from the hair so that they can both be corrected separately. And as I mentioned before, this method can be used for removing color, as we're doing here, also adding color as we did in the previous tutorial. I'm going to use the shape mask. So click the little square icon at the top of the inspector and select add shape mask. The circular mask appears on the viewer. So first rotate the mask to the angle of the face. Then using the green dots, resize the mask to fit the face and drag into position over the face. Use the white dot to square off the oval. Now adjust to have the inner circle just cover the face and not the hair. So next, drag the outer circle that affects the feathering of the mask so that there's no feathering over the hair. And you'll also notice that I'm on the inside of the circle. Select the outer circle, and while the eyedropper is blue in the hue versus sat line, click again in the yellow here and drag the resulting dot down. Now select the inside button and drag the previously created dot up until there's enough color in the face. I'll go back to the video tab at the top of the inspector and disable the hue and saturation blue tick, and you can see the before and after. Watch out for the next video showing how to add split screens in Final Cut Pro without any additional plugins. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe and press the bell.